Okay, let's have a look at these four questions. Starting with this one. So, tan is sine over cos. Probably a good idea to get it all onto one side. You always get rid of fractions if there are any. So there's no thinking to be done so far. And this is just a factorizable expression. So pretty straightforward, I think. Get rid of fractions. Okay, next one. Now there's two ways of doing this question. A lot of you went for this solution, which is fine. You multiply everything by sine cos, and you get this. Some of you are missing out the theta, writing things like 3 sine cos theta. Well, just be careful. Now this is you simplify this. Because sine squared plus cos squared is equal to 1. But now this is tricky. This is not at all obvious what to do and a bit too advanced at the moment. What I'm going to do is use the sine 2 theta formula. There it is, it's on the formula book. So I'm going to make this equation look like the formula by multiplying both sides by 2. Now, I've created a 2 sine theta cos theta on the right-hand side. So I can replace that with sine 2 theta and then divide both sides by 3. Have a look at that. That's a little bit advanced for where we are at the moment. And so therefore this wasn't a great starting point. Instead, using the fact that cot theta is 1 over tan theta is a better starting point because this you've got to train yourself to recognize this. What is this style of equation? Let's say x plus 1 over x equals 3. Well, it's a quadratic, that's all. So you can rearrange this to make it equal 0 and then solve it as a quadratic, either by factorization, which doesn't work in this case, or you just use your calculator. Next one. Well, whenever you have a mixture of 2 theta and 1 theta, we don't want that. So we're going to use the standard cos 2 theta formula. It's just that there's three of them. You've got to make sure you choose the right one here, the one that's going to create the least problem. And that is clearly this middle one. And so we put in the formula for cos 2 theta. And this is just, again, a quadratic in sine theta, although a simple one. And so sine theta is equal to plus or minus square root of a third. So you should then write sine theta equals a third, a root a third, and sine theta equals minus root a third, and then solve those two things separately. Lastly, this pretty tricky question. Well, we can just replace everything. There is another way of doing this that we haven't covered yet, but sorry about my desktop chiming. So I'm just going to replace it by all the standard things. Now, you should be thinking, I've got to get rid of fractions. So we're going to multiply everything by cos squared theta. And we get that. Now, this is a mixture of coses and sines that we certainly do not want. But we can easily replace sine squared with 1 minus cos squared using the formula cos squared plus sine squared equals 1. Now this is just a quadratic in cos that you need to simplify it and then solve it as a quadratic. Okay, that's it.